I'm Greg Archer, and this is American Idol. Well, it's not really American Idol, but it's American Idol night at Pizza My Heart. James Durbin's fans are here. They've shown up to show their support, as they do every night here and other places. But Pizza My Heart is hopping. We're going to go in, and we're going to join some of the fun. How's James going to do tonight? Will they love him? Probably. So you come to Pizza My Heart every Wednesday night, pretty much, right?
Pretty much, since the beginning, yeah. It's a scene. A lot of us have just become friends that didn't even know each other before, but we know each other's names, we save each other's seats now. The people who know him are just so happy to watch him come out of a really rough childhood and a really tough high school years and find himself and now be a father and be grounded and Tourette's people all over the world are just posting about him on their websites. He's become their hero.
He gives me goosebumps every time he sings, no matter what he sings. He's just enchanting. That's really on the word. He just draws you in no matter what he sings.
You shook me, baby. You shook me all night long.
When I was younger, I was diagnosed with Tourette's. And when I sing, it just all goes away. I don't have a care in the world.
Such an inspiration as we've been reading in the local news to all other young people with similar disabilities. The fan base is beyond just musicality. It's other people that can relate to his backstory.
He was born out of this soil of a lot of creativity and a lot of outside the box. And he was nurtured through local theater with Kids on Broadway and others, with local musicians. The community nurtured this kid, and that's why he doesn't fit in a box neatly.
You can sense his confidence. He hasn't let it get in his way. He's actually utilized it to perform and to grow.
The one thing that has been really amazing to watch about James is his being a very genuine person. That is something that is really coming through when he is on the program. He's amazingly talented.
He's very dynamic, and he really knows how to put on a show. He knows how to play to the audience. He's incredible.
Are you going to vote tonight?
Yeah.
You going to tell your friends to vote?
Yeah.
He's come so far. He's really overcome.
He always kills it on stage and does an amazing performance.
I think he can sing anything. I love the one time he sang heavy metal. I don't really like heavy metal, but he said, you know, something like give heavy metal a chance, and I thought he was amazing. You got another thing. He's like the boy next door. Everybody can embrace him, and we can't wait till he comes to Santa Cruz.
What do you think makes James stand out? Why do you think people keep showing up here for him?
Because he's the best singer, and he has a great talent.
He's really sexy.
He's sexy? He kind of has that look you like, huh?
Yeah.
Because he's good at rock and roll. You can tell he can sing soul. He can sing some love songs.
Yeah. Do you have a crush?
He's cute.
So what do you think people are showing up for? I mean, obviously James is a good singer, but there seems to be something more than just him being a good singer. So what are people resonating with, do you think?
I asked him what his plans were, what his ideas were, where he wanted to go. And he said, you know what? I've got a kid on the way, and my family's first thing in my heart. That's what everything else is going to have to wait. So what about going on the road? What about recording with some cats? I know people that you'd love to play with, man, and they love to play with you. And it's all going to have to wait. From that point forward, James has been a hero of mine. He's awesome.
Completely, you give your love so sweetly. Will you still love me tomorrow?
This guy just might win the whole thing!
I think if James Durbin were a pizza, he'd be half pepperoni and half like veggie complexo with like this like stuff sprinkled on top with spice, you know, like a lot of spice. That's what I think. All right, if James were a pizza, what would he be?
He'd probably be the deluxe combination.
Yeah, I like that. Thin crust or thick?
Oh, thin.
Thin?
He's got a little bit of a thin, he's got, you know, he's all heart.
Something with garlic.
Wow. Wow.
Probably some garlic.
Garlic is purifying.
And then add a lot of this.
Mushroom, juicy mushroom, savory.
Savory, juicy mushroom.
Mushroom, yeah.
Pesto.
Pesto, why pesto?
Because it's passionate.
I would say pineapple. Pineapples are very sweet, and I don't know, people just like them.
If James Durbin were a pizza, what kind of pizza would he be?
A good pizza?
That's actually one of the best answers we've had tonight.
Maybe pesto with red pepper.
I'd call it rock on. I would have lobster, rock lobster. Yeah, some kind of really spicy pepper.
Combination. Yeah, combination. The one with all of the stuff on it.
He'd need some hot sauce.
What do you think?
I olive.
High five. So how do you think James did?
James did great. He's from the heart. I'll just say it again. And it was wonderful.
I thought James was absolutely brilliant, and he just got me right in the heart, took me back to the 60s. And when I listened to Carole King, and it did the same thing to me now as it did back then.
How do you think he did? It gave me chills too. It gave me chills. We'll see you here next week, right?
Duh.
Duh. I created my own James Durbin slice of pizza. It's a slice of pepperoni. It has a lot of oregano on it. It has cumin. It has pepper. It has lots of cheese, lots of Parmesan cheese. It has a little bit of paprika. Spicy, spicy, spicy. That's my James Durbin pizza. And this is American Idol Night at Pizza My Heart.